Everybody, here we are at Withington Stadium, Jackson, Michigan, for the Class B semifinals between Robichaud and Monroe. Here come the Dearborn Heights Robichaud Bulldogs. There's Joe. There are their opponents, Monroe St. Mary's Catholic Central.
Thank you. Number 24, Robichaud Football. Thank you. everybody. This is Lou Michaels, the voice of Continental Cable. This is really a tribute to these fine young men. All season long, they struggled, they worked hard, they came up with the dream of state championship. Yeah! I've had the pleasure over the last 3 or 4 years to be a part of this program, doing the sports, knowing gentlemen like Ron Tarrant, Bob Yock, the coaching staff. What a great bunch of men, tremendous, and a fine bunch of athletes that Bob Tarrant and his fine staff have coached over the last 3 or 4 years. These are fine young men. This is definitely a tribute to a great, great season. And it's you fans that support the team and everybody else that contributes to a fine program. And I'm glad to be a part of it. I'm glad that the Bulldog bit the other Bulldogs along the way, and we gave away Bulldog Biscuit! it was very funny. I just have one thing to say. I don't very rarely wear a tux. I'm just a plain ordinary guy that enjoys being with the fans and being with the people and being with these young men and young women. It's a great, great tribute to a season. I walked in and Brenda Alexander met me at the door this morning. She says, "My God, Mr. Michaels, you sure look like a Robichaud Bulldog, baby." I love it. And I'm glad to be associated with Robichaud. I'm glad to be associated again with the fine young people that make this school possible. And I hope that I will be here a long time to bring you football, Bulldog power, Biscuit power. Let's hear it! Let's hear it! Let's hear it! And, you know, We talk about the tribute to the champions. The tributes like the Tyrone Wheatleys, the Ernie Baskins, the Andrew Parhams, Sonny Coopers, and the rest of the fine team that make up the 1919 state Class B champions. But there are other people that are involved in this situation too. And they are to the left of me. Those are the cheerleaders. Those are the people that get you excited. Enthusiastically excited. I'm going to introduce them to you. This is the cheerleaders of the 1990 State Class B Champions, the Bulldog Cheerleaders. Starting off, the coach, Deborah Sample. Jamie Sullivan. Azure D. Weaver. Charlotte Chapman. Tarina Elliott. Jennifer Stubby. Corrine McGowan. Tyra McCullough. Kendra Kelly! also want to mention the music department. They were instrumental, a play on words, of course, bringing you the entertainment all season long. The fine young men and young women worked just as hard doing the marching, preparing all season long, just like the 1990 State Class B Bulldog Robichaud High School team. And let's give them a big hand. I know you young people have supported the Bulldogs all season long, and seasons in and seasons out. What we have here is, you can't touch this, a video of what happened, a little highlight of what happened during the 1990 Dream to the Silver Dome. Let's take a look at that and enjoy it. It's your 1990 State Class B Bulldog! Bulldog Power! Bulldog Biscuit!
Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
Back to the road, knocked down! What a play by Irving!
cautious as to who gets the ball this time. Wheatley off to this side. He's got a man to beat her up. Great block! Great block by Steve Gill. Spring Wheatley.
Oh, yeah.
3 minutes to go. Farhand hands the ball off. Cairo trying to cut the outside. Stiff arms. He's out his way. Good ball!
Yeah.
Unbelievable!
Woo.
What a run by Cairo Wheatley. I'm telling you, folks.
Well, you've got an opportunity to see a little bit of the highlights of the 1990 State Class B champions. And without remiss, Coach gave me this. I'm going to let you look at this. He gave this to me at the beginning of the season. Hey, if you talk about you fans being the number one Bulldog, I'm the biggest Bulldog in the city of Dearborn! Tell you, as I alluded to in the beginning of this whole tribute to the champions, it's these fine young men that have worked together all season long through the rain. We didn't have any snow, but through severity, through some injuries, through the good times, through the bad times, we had an opportunity to broadcast as many games as we could on Continental Cable. The only loss, and I feel bad about that, because it could have been an undefeated season. But nevertheless, it's probably one of the greatest seasons. I'm going to bring him up here. Coach Ron Tarrin can say in his coaching career, the undisputed champions of Michigan and of the world, the Bulldogs, Ron Tarrant, the head coach! I'm sorry. I get excited. Bob Young, I don't think Ron Tarrant would object any. He was a part of it. Anyway, Bob. That's what happens when you're in this business. You get so excited, you mix up names, but who cares? It's a tribute to a championship season. I'm going to let Bob Yock introduce the 1990 State Class B Bulldogs. Go ahead, Coach. Let's hear it out there for Bob Yock!
Thank you, Lou. This has been truly a rewarding year as a coach and for our school. Now, I've been coaching here at Robichaud for 21 long seasons, and probably the greatest thrill that I've had as a coach was playing here in the playoffs for the first two playoff games, and even though we won, was to turn around and see our stands full of Robichaud fans, community supporters, encouraging our young men on. It was a great thrill just to see our stands full. It's taken 21 years to do that, but I'll tell you, it was a great thrill. It was a great thrill walking the Silver Dome. There are a lot of people responsible for the success of this team. I would like to acknowledge a couple of them while we are here and have time to do that. I want to thank Deborah and the cheerleaders because they have had a long season. Normally, we played 9 games. This year, we had 13 games, but they have been very supportive throughout the season. Again, I want to thank Deb and all the cheerleaders. Let's give another round of a hand. I also want to pass along this compliment to our Robichaud band. It's also been a long time since we've had a marching band. And at the end of each game, I had many people, alumni, fans, the parents come up to me and say, please pass on the compliment to the band and to the band instructor for a job well done. We are very proud that you have restored pride in our community with our band, and keep up the good work. Lynn Cleary and the band, please stand. I just want to say we did look good at intermission and before the game with our marching band. We're very proud of you and your accomplishment. I also want to recognize one of our real hard workers throughout the year, who's our statistician, ran a lot of errands for the team, took a lot of photos, and she's been with us for 2 years, Millie Hurst. Millie, stand, please. I want to thank Mr. Tarrant, our athletic director, who was very supportive throughout the year. It was a long season for him. We cut into his basketball season. Sorry about that, Ron, but again, thank you. And Late Jones, who was our man in the press box all season long and did some scouting for us, a very valuable man, Mr. Jones. And then, of course, I would be remiss in not introducing, because they are played a very large part in the success of this team, our coaching staff. I think I'm very proud of these young men. They've done a great job in bringing these men along and developing their skills and upgrading their performances. Shelby Johnson, assistant coach. Shelby Johnson. And our line coach, Coach Robert Yelk. Now, about this team, I'm very proud of their accomplishments and their success. We've had a very outstanding group of players, and especially our senior class. They have been together throughout the year. They worked together in harmony. They were committed. They were not individualistic. They always played towards our team goals, and they were probably, in my mind, one of the better senior classes that we've had in many, many years. And it's because of their leadership, their commitment, their discipline, their dedication, that we had the success that we did. At this time, then, I'll start with our freshmen and introduce them. If you would come forward, each one of them will receive a certificate from the Michigan High School Football Coach Association and a souvenir program. They have received at this time individual medals that were awarded at the regional game and at the state finals. Let me begin with Bobby Kelly, freshman. Sophomores, a quarterback who had kind of a big game for us as a backup quarterback, and we expect good things from him in the future, Michael Orsetti. Sophomore middle linebacker, who probably will fill in, I think, very nicely next year, at middle linebacker, Ivory Burks. Sophomore with a lot of speed, not a lot of size, but has great potential as receiver, Ahmed Haydar. Sophomore guard, Gerald Rice. And then the biggest man in Wayne County, Alex White. The other day I had a chance to visit with his mother, and I said, you know, Alex, I said, Mrs. White, I watch your son eat in the cafeteria every day, and he has a salad. Tell me, how does he eat at home? And after she informed me as the amount of food this young man eats at home, now I understand why, Alex, you're 6'8 and 3 what, 18? Juniors. Tailback, cornerback, Eddie Lawrence. Our starting tight end, outside linebacker, junior Jamal Bohannon. A cornerback, running back, Derek Rendles. Probably the smallest starter on the team, but pound for pound, one of the toughest young men we have on our team. At a cornerback, number 12, and our captain for 1991, Steve Gill. A backup running back, cornerback, Tyrone Ray. Split in receiver, Roberto Clalix. Our starting outside linebacker, junior, all league, all city, all area, all everything, Gary Phillips. Our starting center for 2 years, he's coming back and probably one of our most consistent blockers, a steady performer, and he's going to play two ways next year. I already told him that. Joe Reyna. A backup guard will be our starting guard next year, Jim Chapman. Hard for me to believe that his dad is sitting up there in the back of the gymnasium up here. He played for me in 1970. He tells me I'm getting old. Mr. Chapman, stand up. A backup lineman, Reuben Holt. Offensive defensive tackle, junior, Daryl Sneed. A tight end, split in, Richard Johnson, junior. And now our senior class. I'm real proud of this young man. Towards the end of the season, he really came on strong and played outstanding for us as a defensive tackle, number 70, Robert McLean. A very quiet young man, intelligent, steady performer. Somebody we really didn't count on this year, but made a big contribution for us, Dennis Norton. Another young man who came on we really didn't count on, has played an offensive guard and a defensive tackle, Clarence Whitelaw. I'm really proud of this young man. He didn't finish last season, but he committed himself this year. We invited him back out, and he became one of our starters on defense, Floyd Moran. Our middle linebacker and the quietest member on our team, who is all league, all area, all city, et cetera, et cetera. One of our leading players on the team defensively, a steady blocker on offense. And as I said, a very quiet young man. If you ever see him in the cafeteria, he hardly ever talks. Sonny Cooper. Oh. This man, the next person, looks like a basketball player, but he was our leading defender against the pass. He intercepted 9 passes on the year. He was our leading receiver on offense. Just a great athlete and a great team player, Greg Murphy. This next young man didn't see a lot of action, but you have to admire his courage. When he was a young boy, he had leukemia. But this young kid was at practice every day for the past 3 years, did his best. And I got to introduce Brandon Hayes. Another surprise for this season. We did not anticipate a lot of performance, a lot of playing time, but came on to be our starting fullback and our starting defensive end, one of the major players in our whole offensive and defensive schemes, Ralph Irvin. Another young man who's on the basketball team, didn't finish last year, but came on to be a real threat as a receiver. And caught some key passes for us all season long, William Fleming. This young man that I'm about to introduce was probably the biggest surprise of the whole 1990 campaign. Filled in nicely at quarterback and led us to some key wins in the win against Luther North. He threw the winning touchdown pass in overtime and really opened up our offense, Andre Parham. He started for us for 3 years. He was all everything, all state, first team, class B. He's being sought after by many colleges and universities as a college student athlete. And we're very proud of this young man's accomplishments, Ernie Baskin. The final member of our senior class, I want to give you some statistics about this young man. I'm sure you know who I'm talking about, but he set about a dozen school records. Let me share a couple with you. He's established the most points scored for a single season at Robichaud with 252 points, which makes him the number 2 all-time career high school football player in the state of Michigan, with a career total of 484 points. That's quite an accomplishment for a young man who played the first 4 games at quarterback, then come on and play tailback and rush for over 2,010 yards. His career record puts him over 4,000 yards. He's Mr. Everything. It was just a great pleasure for me to work with this young man and this team this year. I give you Tyrone Wheatley. Thank you, Luke.
I'm sorry for the delay. Coach took the... As part of show business, you got to have the script or you ad lib. All I can say, again, and I want to enlighten on this, these young men that will go on, the seniors, Tyrone Wheatley's, the men that are seniors, they're a tribute to your school. They're a tribute to your community. They're a tribute to the moms and dads. I never really had the pleasure to sit down and talk with Tyrone Wheatley, a man who has done everything, and the other young men that have surrounded him during the season. But I'll tell you one damn thing. It's one of the nicest bunch of young guys. They are the Dog Biscuits! Roof, 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 roof! Again, this is really a dream season. Hey, coach, you want to bring the young man up? Come on.
Dennis Norton's at the Taylor Career Center. This is Dennis Norton, our starting tackle.
As I said, it's a tribute to the champion season. It's a tribute to the fine young men, the moms and dads, the people that have partaken all season long. I don't know if this is customary or not, but I've been working with these guys for the last 4 years, and they get tired of seeing me saying, "Hello, everybody, this is Lou Michaels. Hey, I want to thank the guys in the truck. I want to thank our technicians. I want to thank everybody that's been involved in Continental Cable that could bring you these games all season long, to bring you the entertainment of these fine young men, the stars of the future." Hey, there's one thing to say. 2P! Next year, we're coming back bigger and better! Roof, 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 roof! I want to thank everybody that has come out to this fine tribute to the champions, and they are the champions. I want to say a very special thanks to some people, Ron Tarrant, Jan German, Ken Ferguson, and a real thank you to the lady who got the transportation to take you people to those championship games, Brenda Alexander! Again, ladies and gentlemen, this has been Lou Michaels. Everybody have a good day and a good tomorrow. We'll see you in January. Basketball, your sports connection all season long. Lou Michaels, bye-bye! Again, we want to thank you all. I love it. Hey, they say little boys with big toys. I'm a big man with a big toy with a whole bunch of nice guys over here. Come here, Coach. Coach Bob Yock. Hey, Coach, that's great. We'll see you in January, everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Lou. Thank you, Continental Cable TV, for your fine cooperation. A reminder, as you come down out of the stands, watch the cords on the floor so that you don't trip. Thank you for your attention. You're now excused.